Hey guys, welcome back to the next episode of 7 Days to Die. I've actually got quite a bit done. Just quickly want to put this in here. I just want to show you guys. I have all these forges going. I'm making some steel. And then also, look how full my chests are again. You might be wondering how, and this is the answer. I can't believe an auger is this useful. You blaze through all the resources. It was actually better than using the TNT because you maintain your resources. With the TNT, some of the resources fall through the world. So I just forgot to put this one on, so it's a little behind. So what I want to do this episode is, I also want to show you guys why I got so much stone. But I just quickly want to put a few things up here. Screamers outside. Ooh, you see, now this staircase is obsolete. Damn, I'll have to change that a bit. We'll have to start further out. Oh, and you just need to add a door. No, I can't. I'll just remove that staircase. I didn't even notice that. As you can see, I put blocks up with the names, signs. And then each safe has its own type of gun. And then I just quickly want to do this area, and also as you can see, I did a bit of the roof, because if you just do two blocks, it's gonna take too long to wait for it to dry and it's gonna waste episode. And I made everything steel, so it actually carries everything in the middle. Also with these ramps here, the chishing ramps with the steel wall, this roof can't fall in now. It's impossible. Well, I hope it's impossible. Okay, let's just hope that this doesn't cave in. Might just have to. Okay, let's see. 1, 2, that's 3. Okay, no, it should hold. Cool. Okay, so I want to make this a half kind of study area. So let me see if I can get this up straight. So this is going to be the study slash bedroom slash gun room. Because I want to save most of my resources for that new build. Also, let's quickly read all of these, because when I'm out exploring and I kill animals, then I don't gain anything. But if I have these read, then at least I get the XP. Also, for the guys new to these kinds of quests, all the animal quests don't have a timer, but the zombie quests all have timers. Okay, let's see, where can I put these? Just on the floor. This is just gonna be to liven up the room a bit. Because I already have storage for all the guns, so there's no actual need for these munition boxes. As soon as I get more lockers and bookcases, I want to put them up here. Unfortunately, both traders are out of these now. Okay, so we also need a table. Let's see if a desk works. Okay, so let's put it. Since the bookcase and everything's gonna be like that, I think this should be fine. Let's just put the fuse box outside. There's no need for the fuse box, but it's just to be that little bit more realistic, you can say. Okay, on top of the roof, I'm gonna place the air conditioners. Let's place one inside. Because you're in South Africa, you can place the air conditioner inside the house to actually make it a little bit colder. So the rest I wanna put upstairs, and then these we can go downstairs with. Also, I need to remember I need to make a chair for this side. Yet another screamer incoming. Damn, Damn, I was off. Now I spawned zombies. Strange there aren't that many zombies that spawned. Yet another screamer, let's see if I can get this one. Bullseye, and I thought I killed that bee, or was it a second bee? Come on. No, 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 no! Damn it! Let's just quickly get a splint. That noise is gonna irritate me so much, I have to kill that bee. Okay, so there were two bees, two zombies, and that's all. Huh, interesting. Okay, now to show you guys why I have so much stone. The iron I got from mining in the mines, I also want to show you guys that. But the stone is from this. As you guys know, this is the old tunnel. Definition on old. Like, yeah, this way. So we can drive in from the top, and then we can leave this way. Just go around. I still need to place a roof because zombies can still sense me through the dirt. And then, look at this. This is a perfect tunnel. This is what I intended for the other side. But since I used TNT on the other side, it turned out so ugly. And it goes, it's a perfect slope all the way up, and I also already made that entry thing on the other side. I mean, yeah, I made the pillars. Guys, I apologize if you sometimes hear background noises. My twin brother and I share a room, so I have to use push and talk to talk. He's also a gamer. I have to use push to talk, and sometimes I push just as he wants to sneeze or cough or speak with his friends. I'm actually debating whether it's worth putting the wall on the side. It takes so much time and effort, and you sometimes have to destroy some of these ramps just to be able to dig here. For example, this block, this triangle, is the block behind this. Sometimes if I dig here, I damage the frame, so I have to destroy the frame first. As you guys noticed, this entrance is only 3 wide, so it's perfect for the mini bike. So this one I'm going to say entry, and the other one I'm going to say entrance. Oh, come on, I'm going to lose my wellness. Okay, so I need a roof for here. I need to place these glass blocks on top, and I also need to wait for the roof to dry so I can put the air conditioning down. Since I have the reinforced concrete mix, I actually want to upgrade these to reinforced. There's no need for it, but it's just going to look better. What I also did was, I, as you can see, these blocks fit perfectly now. Last time there was a rift when I was on top. Yeah, I was on top. There was a rift here, so I actually took that out. After the next horde, we'll have enough resources. Oh no! I have to come take this out. After the next horde, I'll have enough resources so that I can start the next base. Because at the moment, I can already start the next base, but we can't face the horde there. We're gonna die. Let's just put this up there for if I do the same mistake again. Now that I think about it, this was actually a waste. This digging, except we got resources from it. Because there's no need to use this when you can use the ladder we used to get to the mini bike. So straight down versus going left, 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 or right, right the whole time. Just hate when I misplace a block that I spent so much time smelting. At least these blocks are cheap. Okay, so I did not take this block out to it. Lovely. Okay, let's see. We need to take this one out. Like so. Okay, so this one side's done. Let's quickly do the other side. No, over here. This rate I'm gonna lose wellness. I keep landing on this leg. I might actually not have enough. No, I will have enough for a moment there, because I worked out 1, 2, 3, so it's 4 over here. I worked out 3 per block, so I thought I might just have not have enough, but I made enough. I actually made more than enough, so if we need it for next build, we have it. I seriously hope that Alpha 16 comes soon, but at the same time I don't want it to come before I finish the new build. Only thing now is if we fall off the top, we won't have any room for escape. So we'll always have to have at least the auger or the pick and axe with us. Otherwise, if we fall down there, we're screwed, because we won't be able to jump on the spikes. Well, it's weird. Sometimes you can jump on the spikes, and other times it's like you're stuck in between. Okay, so that's done for now. I'm not gonna waste iron on the spikes over here. It only needs the last level to look like that, and then we can make it steel. But you guys saw how tough this base is against a horde. It lost, so there's no need to actually do that. It's just a waste. Damn it! I so hope she didn't see me there. No! What the hell? Now I'm dead. I can't believe that just happened. Now how the hell are we gonna get up there? We have to break some glass. Just as I said, we should be careful for this, it actually happens. I'm just so glad I didn't lose any wellness. I'm trying so hard to get to 250 wellness. Luckily this glass is cheap, otherwise I would have been so pissed right now. Okay, let's just hope we don't fall off again. So I still need to make that fence. I need to make a fence on this side. We have a fence on that side, but not this one. Okay, so we have to make an office chair and a fence. And then fix this leg. Okay, so for the office chair, 5 leather, 10 cotton, 2. Okay. I'm just glad the spikes handled all the zombies up here. Okay, now where is the cotton? I could have sworn we had cotton left. So I have to go outside quickly just to get cotton. 2 mechanical parts. Also. 3 forged iron. As you guys can see, I used up almost all the gas mining. I need to take all the steel out. Let's just quickly do this. Also want to go outside quickly before it gets dark, so we can quickly get all the cotton. Okay, so now we can make the chair. No chair. What am I missing? Ah, the cotton. Okay, let's just quickly get that. Hopefully there's no other screamers out here. Let's see, where can I find cotton? It seems to be in front of the base. Okay, let's just do this. I should actually take the mini bike out, but there's no need for that at the moment. Just a shame that I'm moving so slow now due to the broken leg. I have to be super careful now not to run into another screamer, because he spawns dogs and stuff, then I can't run away with this bum leg. And they usually spawn over there. Ooh, a field of cotton, awesome. I should also make a farm over here, but I don't want to. We already have the farm next door, so there's no need to make another one. Let's see, 21, just enough for one office chair. Should actually plant this cotton and make more of it. You always need cotton for the most random stuff. So as you can see, I already did this outside, now we just still need to do the woods for both sides. Ooh, also, as you guys can see, I also did the stairs outside. So, in between everything, I had enough resources to make the concrete stairs and upgrade them as well. So, things have been going great for me in this game. Where is that zombie? You know what? I should actually show you guys while I'm out here quickly. I'm just going to put on God mode for this, it's easier to show you, it's faster. I want to show you guys the mines. Look how huge this became. Last time I showed you it was just about this much and I did all this extra. And there's quite a bit of iron and stuff with it, so it's awesome. There's still a ton of iron in here, as you can see, especially on top and at the very bottom. So, and the new veins that I discovered. So I still need to do all of this. It's gonna take a while. This looks so much neater than that one over there. Okay, this is almost dry, so we can just well stop here. Air conditioner. Okay, we still need the other one. Damn. Let's just hope I don't injure my leg more. Perhaps I can make a ladder up back here, so it's up to the roof. Let's just quickly do it now. So I still need to get that one air conditioner out the side of that passage. And then I can put both air conditioners on top. I still need to find out if I can make the iron pieces go with it. This side. Let's just quickly put away a few things. My inventory is getting a little bit cluttered. All the building stuff that we're not using anymore, we can put here. We can put the coins away for now. Can use these. I'm gonna keep the splint on me since I keep injuring my leg. So this is the last bit of steel. Wait, we can make more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and craft. Why does it say I can't craft? Now I can. Let's quickly go up and then. Oh, wait. First, we need that one air conditioner. I believe it's... Oh, damn it! See, that's why I keep the splint on me. Once you've broken your leg, it's so damn easy to break it again. Oh, I forgot you can't pick it up. Damn, and I can't make my own, can I? I bought these two. That was a waste. I forgot that you can't pick it up. It's just the spotlights that you can pick up. Okay, so now we're stuck with one air conditioner. I'll put this upstairs, and then where do I put... just want to quickly fill up that one block, and I'll have you guys back on top. Okay, so before I go up, I just quickly want to place these fences so I don't fall off the side again. I hate it when it bugs out like this. I have to clear this whole thing and press escape because it keeps entering there when I press E to leave. I actually intend on getting the whole base to steel before starting the new base, but that shouldn't take that long. And we already have all that steel, so that should be enough for all the stairs outside and the flooring. And then all that's left is this building over here. But this building isn't even necessary because as soon as the horde arrives, you just pick up the bridges like this. So the only thing that I need steel is the defense. As soon as I have the outside steeled up, then I'll go to the new base. Only bad part about the second or the fourth floor is it's outside, so it's easy for zombies to spot you from over there. Okay, so this we can put. Let's put it at an angle, like so. So we have our office, or study, or whatever you want to call it. We just need a little bit more bookcases, and then here we can put our lockers, and also maybe I can put a small wall up here, and then it can be like a locker room with a toilet or something. I'm not sure. Okay, and the bedroom, I'm not going to focus too much on the bedroom. Wait, this isn't upgraded. I'm not going to focus too much on the bedroom because all we need is the bedroll. I should technically make this whole roof steel so that I know it stays up. Because it can still easily fall if there's too much weight, but if everything is steel, then each block can carry 16 other blocks. Let's just also do this so I know where to walk down every time I get here. Don't want to fall off this high roof. Okay, so the kitchen's done, the top floor's done, more or less. Still need the... I don't think we can make those. I don't even know what they're called. There's iron pieces that goes with the air conditioner that you usually find on roofs. I don't know what it's called. The piping. Okay, so let's just see, what do I need to do next? I still need to do the roof at the bottom. Fence we can put away. Before I go downstairs and do everything there, let's just put these away. And then, okay, I need this on me and the wood on me. But what I want to do now is quickly put more stone in so we can get even more concrete mix. We have the stone for it, so why not? Okay, let's see, we have 5 for the stone, we can use these 2, but I want to use these 5 for steel again. So just 5, that's 10. Turn on, why is it not going? Oh, wood. The moment that I thought the game was bugged. Just shows, before you complain about anything in this game, make sure you're not the one doing anything wrong. I'd rather do a lot of iron like this. Instead of 1,000 iron and 500 clay, which is uneven and you don't know the amount of wood, I'd rather put 1,000 and this amount of wood, and then clay of 1,000 divided by 2 for 5, and then you just divide the wood in half. Okay, now that's going, we can just grab a little bit more wood. Rather, let's just stack these inside and then take from the inside. We have all the plates we need. Rebar we don't need at the bottom, it'll take it along with us. Yeah, let's quickly go downstairs. Just have to be careful for more screamers now since we have the forges on again. When working with wood, I should actually hold my fire axe with me, or keep my fire axe with me, because I can use the auger, but it wastes gas, and the pickaxe is just too slow. The only reason I have only these two items on me now is because I was mining with them. I actually timed it. In the time it takes the steel pickaxe to take down one block of iron, the auger can take two blocks of iron down. So that's why I'm actually using only the auger in mining. The pick is just there for if I run out of gas. And don't have to run back to base every now and then. Oh, it won't take that long. So let's just quickly, if we have enough left, do that as well. And then we know for sure that this area is done. See, there will be gaps over like that. Oh well, I'll close those gaps on my own later on. I mean, what are the chances that a screamer sees you through a small hole like that? You should actually see how fast it took me to dig this hole with my... let's make 150 this time. With my auger. Where it took almost a whole night just to do the other side with TNT, it took less than a night just using the auger. Which shows the auger is a lot faster than TNT. Also, an auger is a lot safer. All you need to watch out for is falling debris. With a TNT, the blast range can sometimes get you, even if you think you're far enough away. I'm actually considering skipping this war day, and then just mining away, and then a few days into, just before the following war, I want to go to the build site and start building. Just don't want to take too long. As you guys know, my in-game days are set to 90 minutes. So it takes so long just to if you're mining for an hour and a half and only one in-day game has gone by, you actually get demotivated. You guys, this is more of a boring episode. There's no zombie killing involved. But you guys said that you wanted a series that's mostly building. So the hordes in between is just a perk I give to the people that actually want to see some zombie killing. Ooh, so close. Okay, so I like actually just doing this, so I know where all the words should be. Trends. I think this might just be a little too much for the other side, but we'll test it and see. As you guys can see, I still have a lot of, oops, no, don't want to do that. I have a lot of iron left here, and then they're going to use all of that up for the spikes on the other base. The other base is going to be fairly large, since I'm not going to make a storied building, I'm going to make a flat one-story building. Okay, so we can quickly go downstairs to the mini bikes and hope a screamer doesn't see us. Mini bikes on the other side. The only thing I definitely want is on the other side. On the other side where we want to build. I want to make sure it's as flat as this. Guys, remember, if the higher up you build, the more chance there is of zombies actually digging underneath you. If it's flat like this and there's no other flat areas except for so far away, then the chance of them digging underneath your base is very scarce. Except for example, say I'm using this mine. And I mine down and underneath my base, then they can go underneath your base and wreak havoc. So I want to try and avoid that as much as possible. So we just need the E. I can put one block on there. It's going to look ugly, but hey. Okay, and now to go to the other side. Let's just hope there's no zombies chasing us. Okay, let's see if it's going to happen again or not. No, so I just placed it wrong, I guess. If I had wood on me, do I? No. There's no wood in the vicinity. I need wood so I can just place the other blocks along as well. But I don't have to worry about that again. This is wood. Just need 10. I can't understand why some people die when the zombies charge them like that. They have ample time to aim and shoot. Okay, it looks a little bit off, but hey. And since we have entrances on both sides, we can just... That makes me mad. I just noticed those blocks aren't dry. And they're not gonna dry, because it's been like that for a while now. For some reason, the game just doesn't wanna dry certain blocks. That one upside down frame, or ramp frame, is also still wet. See how slow you have to go down here, since you keep on falling down a level. On the other side, you just drive down, it's lovely. Okay, now the outside is mostly done, except for the steel that we still need to do. You know what, we were just outside. Why do I keep doing things the hard way? I need to place steel on the outside. Obviously, the blocks that keep refusing to dry, I cannot and will not be able to make steel. I'm just quickly gonna upgrade the top stairs. I'm not gonna switch out the bottom stairs since they never get damaged. So there's no reason for that. I'm just gonna quickly upgrade these stairs and then the floor to steel. Damn screamer. Stand still. Okay, now what the hell did she spawn? As long as she didn't spawn any dogs or bears, I'm happy. They all seem to have died on the other side. Look at all the corpses over here. That's how many screamers keep showing up. Apologize for revving in the background. My little brother has a sports car kind of car. They're almost all the way around. And this is the only steel we have left. So unfortunately I won't be able to go all the way around, but at least I'll have done almost all the other outside, so that's okay. Damn, I need concrete mix. There's so many screamers always showing up to the... because of the forges of the heat map, that as you can see, most of the spikes keep on getting destroyed. And they're tough spikes, so you should know how many screamers show up. Damn, ran out of steel. Okay, at least we were able to go almost all the way around. Only halfway. Damn. Well, more than halfway. If it stopped there, it was halfway. I can't believe we just used that much steel. Okay, so I'm just gonna keep on cooking some resources, so I can finish up this last bit of flooring and stairs. And then next time you guys see me, this base should either be steel or we get ready to go to the new base. I think it will be the latter, since I said I'm gonna try and skip this ward. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna hole up in one of the houses overnight. Remember guys, if you don't kill the zombies, they don't spawn more zombies. So it's an easy way for you to live out the night. If you keep on killing zombies, you encounter more zombies. If you guys like this episode, please leave a like and share with your friends. Guys, we're almost done with this build, then we can start our new build in the snow biome. So if you guys have any comments or feedback on this episode, please leave that down below. And if you guys are new to this channel, please remember to subscribe for more of these videos. See you guys next time.